Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Sadly, this is the finale. There's a bunch of stuff that you unlock after beating the game, and you unlock a very, very special level if you get all the trapped villagers, which is the extra vision right down here. By the way, this map was the most confusing map in the world to navigate unless you use the left and right buttons. Like, I'm gonna press up over here, and it takes me over to 1-1 for some reason. If I press up there, it takes me to the extra vision. I don't get it, man! I don't get it! Like, if I do it here, it'll take me to 1-1. I don't know. Anyway, let's start with the extra vision right now and then do the rest as we go. I'll start with, you know, just keep pressing right as we go to navigate the map screen and do everything in order. I don't think this is canon to the storyline, but it's fun.
Look at that! Balue's tower is all finished!
Remember way back in Vision 1-1? This is the tower that he was building. Dear lord, this guy's invincible.
What's going on?
None of your business. I'm not gonna let some wit behind your ears, little kid. Go around making eyes and using spool talk with my feast. No way!
No! What? This is blasphemy. Oh, come on! Even Hupo's like, no. As you can tell, this takes place after the world has already been saved. So, why is Klonoa here? This is why I don't think this thing is canon, the stage right here. But as I said, it is very fun. It is, without a doubt, the hardest stage in the game, and it is a time attack sort of level, trying to get through the stage as fast as you can. Don't bet on being able to get through the stage all that fast. Notice that you'll get 9 lives right off the bat. Well, there's a good reason for that. This is a pure, difficult, obstacle course level of death. And it starts out fairly easy, but you'll see later it gets ridiculously hard. And I mean ridiculously hard for once in this game, even though this game has been pretty easy. No, 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 no! Oh, poopers. Yeah, there's a bunch of lava around the place that's a one-hit kill, and I just flubbed that one up pretty bad, but that's okay. Come on, I need to get the other guy back up there. It'll take me a couple of tries to get through each of these obstacle courses thingies. It's just how this level rolls. Because of the way its difficulty is, you have to do a lot of enemy jumps like that to progress. Yeah! Alright, I made it. That's the first part. And after every part, you get a checkpoint, and then you can move on. But the time keeps going no matter what. Alright, some more enemy jumps. Finger acrobatics of death! Yeah, it may take you a lot of practice to get through these stages. Well, get through this level, I should say. You know, get through each of these parts. And as you can see, there isn't any trapped villagers because, well, the game is over, practically. But the game isn't over until you beat the stage, in my opinion. I'm terrible with those little propeller guys. Just gonna say that right now. Because I have trouble timing their drop speed and whatnot. Oh, poopers. No poopers. Like, if I were to grab one, I have issues switching off to another enemy and then grabbing another enemy and stuff like that because of the drop time and whatnot. This one, you probably want to follow the crystals to get yourself at the right jump height. Whoa! And I'm not even going to bother with this bonus, really. That seems a little preposterous. Unless you really, really want to 100% getting all those crystals, but as I said, I've never been much for doing that sort of thing. Alright, little birdies, just you and I. Oh, and these guys. Oh, I don't have to do the last one, okay. This is a lot easier than the first time I played it, probably because I got some practice in. This section, however, gave me a lot of ires, and it'll probably give you a lot of ire as well, unless you're really good at these jumps. Oh, poopers! Because you have to go down, then go back up with the critters, and it's just... Oh, that was terrible. I wanted to do my hover jump a little bit lower, but that's okay, I guess. I got so many lives thanks to the silver coins, and ow... This is gonna give me a lot of trouble, isn't it? I have a feeling it's going to give me a lot of trouble. But this will be good entertainment for you. No! Yeah, and you have to have, like, your finger on both the one and two buttons at the same time to be able to jump at the highest possible point you can to move forward. And the quickest possible point that you can. No! I don't think so! Oh, I think so. And there's a lot of long runs just like that in this level that you have to jump your way across using enemies. Oh shoot! Oh, the other one killed off the other enemy! I'm so sad! Alright, I'll get this eventually. Leave you me! No matter how many tries it takes, I will get it! Theoretically, you could stay in the air for as long as you possibly need to. I'm gonna drop that there just so I can use the enemies and try and move forward. Oh yeah! Finally. If you keep trying, you can get through anything. Oh, this part is really annoying. Try and grab... Oh shoot! Try and grab an enemy at the peak of your jump, like throw it out to the side and then grab another one. If you can... Oh, I tried to throw it off to the left and turn around. As I said, I'm not really good with these propeller guys. Because of the timing thing, you have to wait until they explode or you have to throw them and then rapid button press to the other side to grab the enemy. Because obviously you can't throw an enemy into another enemy and you can't lose, your jump height. Otherwise you'll be screwed. and that one just didn't get high enough. And that's another thing, if you grab them on your way of falling down, you'll actually lose jump height. So maybe what I should do is something like this. Oh, this is a lot more effective and a lot easier. Okay, that is definitely something I recommend doing over the other way that I was trying to do. More extra lives, like I need them. Just, did you see my life counter there? Alright, over here you want to kill little plant guys by infinite loop jumping like this and trying not to get in the lava, but no, I guess I'm just have to take a hit there. And alright, here's what you have to do to take advantage of that drop thing. Remember I said that grabbing those things while you're falling will actually make you lose your jump height? Well, you actually want to do that to your advantage on this one. Okay, so jump as high as you can and grab it on your way down and loop around the odd Gordo imitation enemies. Like that, and you should be able to make it. Alright, checkpoints. More of these death jumps. Evil obstacle courses. No, of doom. This level is really fun, though. Definitely worth unlocking. Probably the most fun level in the game, actually, in my opinion. Because of the difficulty and just the craziness of it in general. Oh, and it's got Balue's theme as well, if you didn't notice that. Pretty catchy little tune. Aww. I was mistiming all of my little wind bullets. Come on, we can do this, Klonoa! Concentrate! Yes! No! That gap over there is pretty large. I'm gonna have to, like, jump as I'm falling forward or something like that and then hover. I'm talking about when I actually get past the fourth enemy at this top section. Like, do this and then do that! Do that! Yes! This makes me happy. And another checkpoint. more obstacle courses, and this one you gotta be really, really careful. You'll notice that you have to go around the invincible enemies there. Oh, so close to making it to another checkpoint without dying. I am so disappointed, and I failed to press the button. I should say press it properly. Yeah! And yeah! Needless to say, you cannot do that jump without grabbing the enemy on the other side of Invincible Guy. Oh, that was awesome! You gotta admit, that was pretty awesome, even though it was pretty luck-based. Yeah. But you can tell how to do that part even without me showing you that, because I did that a couple times before in succession. And that's the end of the stage, I think. He's trying to woo her.
Oh, I'm very sorry.
Shut down!
Looks like we're a little too late. Balue's romance didn't last very long, did it?
Poor Balue. Oh, he tried so hard.
I suppose we don't really have to ask if you're okay, do we? Klonoa, Hugo, thank you for worrying about me. I'm so sorry that you two had to come all this way. Well, it's not like we were able to help or anything. No, I apologize for troubling you.
It's not like she was in trouble anyway.
It's Balue who's been causing the trouble. Oh, but Mr. Balue is really a very gentle person. Look, he even gave me this.
A phonograph!
Some kind of machine? Mr. Balue was kind enough to make it for me. It's a wonderful box that plays music. Can you make it play now? Of course, all you do is this.
Aww. Well, at least she likes his gift. And this will unlock the music player, of which I'm going to save right away. Okay. There we go. Now, what I'm going to be doing is going through all these from right to left on my D-pad. I don't know what the heck kind of order they're going to put them in as I press, keep pressing right on the D-pad to continue on through these things. Alright, starting with the costumes, you can pretty much guess what this is going to be. But I'm surprised that these costumes were able to survive this. How are they in such pristine condition? You know, you're going in your blown up house and... yeah, I guess I shouldn't question the game logic. Well, you can choose your regular outfit or three extras.
Hey, let's go.
And he changes very, very quickly. And yeah, whatever. That's really all there is to the costumes. I'm not going to bother showing the other ones just because, well, they're costumes. You can tell what they look like just on the menu. Alright, so next is the time attack. This isn't what you... well, it might be what you think it is. It's not the time attack of the stages, it's time attack of the bosses. So you'll be able to play bosses anytime that you want and race for the best time.
We've been waiting for you. I've lined up some strong enemies so you two can practice.
And by these strong enemies, he, for some reason, thinks Rongo Lango is a strong enemy. So yeah, you can play any of the bosses that you want. I already showed you how to beat all these bosses, so there's no real point in beating these all over again for you. So I'm gonna leave that up to you. I just like to show you guys what each of these extra modes are. Next up, we've got the movie viewer. This is another obvious title here. All the cutscenes in the game you can rewatch, including the ridiculously sad yet beautiful ending scene.
Well, I passed down a tale of Which you want?
None you think. So yeah, I'm not gonna go through these, but you can watch them all over again if you'd want to. Or play through the game all over again if you want to as well. You know, to see them as you go. next, character viewer. Oh, I should have went in here first. I completely forgot about this. To get the names of all the enemies and characters and critters in the game. Okay. Every time I said critter, enemy, thing, guy, replace it with the actual enemy's name, okay? Good.
Is stored here in the temple. I'll let you take a look at it if you would like.
Yeah, I probably just should use my completed save file and just checked out the enemy names. You can check all the characters and get a 3D view of them. Like, I'm going to click on Grandpa here for the heck of it. You can rotate, zoom, stuff like that. And you can do that with each and every enemy and critter in the game. I'm just gonna go through these just to show you the names of all the guys, but I'm gonna do it fairly briskly. So if you want to see something and you can't read as fast as I do, well, pause the video. And yeah, that's pretty much it to this. Not anything else to say. Maybe I'll check out the bosses to get a better view of them. Or at least the final boss, because it was kind of hard to see certain details of him. Well, that armored death move was one of the enemies in the final boss that really got in the way. Let's just check this out. Yeah, normally the floor would be in the way and you wouldn't be able to see his whole character model as well as his back. So that's another cool thing that you can do in this character viewer thing is, you know, see all the enemies' models from all sides.
Well, I'll see you later then.
Some enemies you can't, just by the way that they're placed. Unless you look in the character viewer, of course. Alright, music player!
Come on, let's go!
There's no cutscene to this, though, I don't think. I'm dancing? Oh yeah! Well, there's 44 songs that you can listen to. Any song in the game that you want, you can listen to it. That's a pretty awesome feature, especially since this game has a great soundtrack. And finally, reverse mode. This is exactly what it sounds like. You play the levels in mirror-type mode sort of thing. It's like Mario Kart's mirror mode tracks. They have a purpose in reversing everything! And that's pretty much it. And you'll notice that there's now a little... see that circle next to the reverse mode with the arrow rotating counterclockwise? Now you can play any stage, and you'll be able to play it, as I said, in a mirrored version of itself. I don't believe there's any real difference other than that it's mirrored. As a matter of fact, the... captured villagers that you rescued aren't even rescuable again, if that's even a word. But the signs you can read in normal unreverse mode. But there's no real reason for me to cover this mode because I pretty much covered it in its regular entirety. So I guess I will leave this up to you if you want to play through the levels in reverse all over again. But as for now, I'm going to end off this walkthrough. I hope you enjoyed it. This was definitely one of the more fun walkthroughs I've done, because I love this game so much. I thought I would show off a game that's not all that well known. I love to do that a lot. Like, what I do is... I know mainstream games are good, but what I like to do is show what other games are good, if you know what I mean. A lot of times, but I'll of course play mainstream games every once in a while if they're a favorite of mine or something like that, or if I just want to in general. But that's why I love to play games like this. I love to show cult classics such as this that you might not have, or I should say you might have overlooked otherwise, you might not have heard of, just to give you a little more insight into more of the gaming world that you might not otherwise see unless you pay attention, or I should say look up, and look into special games like this and see which games are highly loved in certain communities and stuff like that. I'm not going to go up there to the windmill because that's actually a place to go get a villager, but anyway. That's really why I love to choose games like this, and one of the reasons why I don't take requests. Again, I always like to say that just to remind you, because how the heck did that even happen? Because the majority of the requests that I get are actually mainstream games, and, well, as I said, we know the mainstream games are good. What other games are good? Klonoa, that's one of them, and I intend on doing more awesome games like this one. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next walkthrough.